governor is taking on public television in his new biennial budget proposal. As we first reported yesterday, it's among several stiff cuts in his plan. Governor LePage wants to eliminate all funding from Maine Public Broadcasting. He says he needs to balance his budget, and the cuts will help. News 8's Keith Baldi is live in Portland with the details. Keith?
Now, Tracy, the president of MPBN says that these proposed cuts came out of nowhere and this will be tough to overcome. The governor's office says they had a budget hole to fill and this worked.
It is 1 minute now before.
It is the only statewide broadcaster in Maine with a strong reach into every nook and cranny of the landscape. In some rural areas, public television is the only channel Mainers get. But proposed changes to the governor's budget would wipe out all state funding to MPBN, $2 million a year, leaving it with 20% less money to operate.
This is unprecedented. We've been in existence for almost 50 years. I don't think there's ever been an effort to entirely cut our budget.
MPBN's president Jim Dow says he does not yet have a full picture of what Maine Public Broadcasting would look like if they lose this money, whether staff would be cut, programming eliminated, or if they would undergo format changes. But he certainly hopes it won't come to that point.
I think people, including me, believe that we provide a great support and value to the culture of the state of Maine, to what's important to the people that live here, believe in.
Maybe so, says LePage spokeswoman Adrian Bennett, but in these tough budget times, she says, it does not justify the government expenditure, especially since they need $164 million to balance the budget, and this proposed cut would help them get there.
The question is, should taxpayers have to subsidize public TV and radio? There are lots of choices, and we feel that, you know, this is a responsible, you know, approach, and it will still leave, you know, consumers with choices.
But it's not a responsible approach this late in the budget cycle, says State Representative Peggy Rotundo, who sits on the Appropriations Committee.
At this point in our process, to put forward such controversial proposals really slows us down and is very disappointing.
At this point, MPBN's president says they're focused on one thing, getting people to tell the state just how important their service is, and much of that will happen on Monday at a public hearing in Augusta. We're live in Portland. Keith Baldi, News 8.